There's a brand new PS5 update you're gonna wanna check out. We got our first look at Spider-Man and Avengers. It's gonna get even harder to find a PS5. And we got our first look at the Black Friday deals for 2021. And before we jump into the PlayStation news, make sure you subscribe and set your notifications to all. So the last time we talked about Marvel's Avengers, it was because they finally did something positive and took all the paid XP boosters out of the game, which people were generally pretty happy about. I know a lot of fans on the subreddit are just kind of over the game at this point. They like buying the movie skins from like Endgame and all the other ones that were added to the game. And then they take pictures and bounce off because there's just not a whole lot to do. And then Crystal Dynamics got a little more positivity for the game when they said on November 30th, we were going to get the new raid that's related to the Black Panther DLC, and also Spider-Man would be added to the PS5 and PS4 version of the game. They teased Spider-Man a few times already in some clever ways. They had a menu over his inventory screen and you could just see the top of his little like mask, which I thought was actually pretty cool. But today we got the full story trailer for Spider-Man. I don't know, I wasn't disappointed by the trailer. I was just kind of walking away underwhelmed. I think from like a looks perspective, he looks great. It looks like Spider-Man. It looks like his comic book costume, which I think is awesome. The one thing that just didn't land for me is the voice.
Just another day being Spider-Man.
He sounds way younger than he looks. Like, they're definitely using a bit of a beefier character model for Spider-Man, but then he's got this like teenager voice. It just didn't really work for me, especially considering how good the voice is in Insomniac Spider-Man. I know there's probably some weird rules there, but the fact that this is an exclusive character to the PS5, I feel like it would have been great cross promotion for Sony to just lend their version of Spider-Man to Crystal Dynamics here, just for this game, because that's kind of like the definitive version of Spider-Man on the PlayStation console, right? Like, the fact that this is also an exclusive Spider-Man means, like, get it figured out. Like, have one Spider-Man that you just use in every game he shows up in. I feel like that's just, like, a fair expectation. The trailer itself was pretty cool. It was very CGI heavy. It didn't actually show any gameplay from what I could tell. It took place in that mini city open world map they have in the game, and seeing all the Avengers teaming up with Spider-Man was pretty cool. Now, they showed a little bit of how he's gonna work. I'm just like hesitant to call it actual gameplay because it looked like the cutscenes, but it looked like he was swinging around the map. He fist bumped Kamala with her big fist. I don't know, it looked cool. I just feel like the Insomniac Spider-Man is so much better than what we're getting here that it's hard to be excited. Also, just the fact that this game doesn't have crossplay, this is exclusive to PlayStation. I know this is like a PlayStation fan channel, but the audience for this game is so fragmented at this point that crossplay would really help out, because it's available on Game Pass, it's available on PlayStation Now. Those are two huge audiences that you could merge together and actually be able to play multiplayer in the game. I don't know, Square Enix seems to have learned that Crystal Dynamics was not a great fit for a live service game, and they're kind of just letting it truck along here. I don't know. If you're excited for Spider-Man, let me know in the comments, because I'm like middle excited. I played this game on PC when it came out, so I'm not gonna start over on PlayStation. That's where I'm at. We've talked about Best Buy Total Tech. We've talked about Walmart Plus. We've talked about how Prime has some weird stuff going on. We've talked about PS Direct, all these different stores that have either paywalls or systems in place to make it so it's harder for scalpers to get them and easier for you to get one. And one that just entered the arena of storefronts that sell PS5s actually seems like a good spot to get one if their servers or whatever hold up. So this one's actually a little unexpected. It's just Verizon, the cell phone company. They're selling PS5s, and the catch is, to get one from Verizon, you need to have a Verizon phone plan, which honestly, I think if I polled all of my friends right now, like my entire friend group, Verizon would be the main cell phone provider they all use. Especially as someone like me from Michigan, everyone in Michigan uses Verizon. That's just how it goes. The cool thing about this is that they're just randomly showing up on the Verizon website. They're not doing drops or anything like that. So if you get bored at work or anything, just check the Verizon site, especially if you're a subscriber to that service, because if you don't have a Verizon plan and then you see the PS5 pop up on their site, there is virtually zero chance you'll be able to subscribe to their like phone service by the time it sells out. I think it's gonna be extremely limited. It's gonna be the same story you've heard everywhere else, but the pool is probably a lot smaller here. I've actually bought stuff from Verizon before, like an Apple Watch, and it went pretty well. So if you haven't gotten a PS5 yet and you're looking for a store that maybe other people aren't checking and you have a Verizon cell phone plan, this might be a good way to go. And like I always say, I tweet out every link I see about PS5s being available. So if you wanna get those notifications, make sure you follow Stay PS Ready on Twitter. Speaking of sales in the holiday season, Black Friday is coming up quick and a lot of retailers are starting to have deals now. Amazon is running a promotion right now where if you buy two games, you get one free, and they have pretty much any game you can think of on there right now. The combo that I've seen highlighted is Call of Duty Vanguard, Far Cry 6, and then Guardians of the Galaxy. Dynasty. Those are three different types of games that are all really good from what I've heard. I know for a fact Guardians of the Galaxy is good because I played through it in like two sittings and I love that game. If you're one of those people who really misses just single player narrative driven games that don't have microtransactions or updates or online connectivity, Guardians of the Galaxy is the way to go. The frustrating thing about that is that it's not very well optimized. So the only two options you get with Guardians of the Galaxy are 4K 30 frames per second and then a performance mode, which is 1080p at 60. And it does not stay at a locked 60 frames per second. It drops down to like 50, 55 at times. But again, the combat in this game isn't like a third person shooter. You have full lock on, you're always just spamming moves from the other characters. So I would go with that fidelity mode because this game has some of the best graphics I've ever seen. Call of Duty Vanguard seems to be splitting the community down the middle. Some people are excited that it has a ton of content, like double the maps of Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, not Black Ops Declassified like I usually say. But then other people are upset because it's an unoptimized mess of a game that has modern guns in a World War II setting. I don't know, I'm not a huge Call of Duty player. I don't even play Warzone anymore, but if you're planning on picking Call of Duty up, you may as well just pair on another game so you can get three total. Far Cry 6 is more Far Cry. I feel like at this point, you know if you like Far Cry, and if you like Far Cry and you haven't picked it up, get it for free with those other two games. Microsoft is running a promotion on their biggest PS5 exclusive of the year, Deathloop. That was weird to say. It's 40 bucks right now. If you haven't played Deathloop, they patched it a few times. It ran like crap at launch, but it runs great now. I went back this week and checked it out. It runs a whole lot better. I think the game is pretty cool. It's a single player game. Once again, it's a little bit more open world than something like Dishonored, and it's a shooter that feels pretty good to play because they worked with Machine Games to get their shooting right on Wolfenstein Youngblood. But unlike Wolfenstein, this is a good game. There's a bunch of games on sale right now at GameStop. Immortals Fenyx Rising was one of my favorite games last year. It's like when you ask for Breath of the Wild and your mom says you got Breath of the Wild at home, but it plays pretty well. I like that game. It's like 15 bucks right now. Back 4 Blood is on Game Pass on Xbox, but on PlayStation side, we gotta buy it. So it's also on sale at GameStop for $49. I have put like 80 hours into that game. I give it my seal of approval. 49 bucks is definitely worth it. Resident Evil Village is my game of the year at this point. I love Resident Evil and I love Resident Evil 7. This was a great follow-up to that, and there just haven't been that many horror games this year, so that's why it's my game of the year. It's on sale on both PS5 and PS4, but even if you have a PS5, buy the PS4 version because it's $20 cheaper at $40, and then there's a free PS5 upgrade. So I feel like you're kind of dumb if you buy the PS5 version. So Xbox made Deathloop for Sony and Sony made MLB The Show, but it's on Xbox Game Pass. I feel like that's the trade-off there. It's on sale on PlayStation where you have to buy it right now for 40 bucks. That's a pretty good deal. And then my sleeper hit of the year, Outriders, is on sale for $19.99. Now this is a game that I think is worth picking up right now because they're doing a huge update for it soon. They haven't said exactly what the update is going to include, but they're saying it's massive. It's gonna revamp the end game. It's gonna add in new guns and armor. That game, again, is my sleeper hit of the year. It's a ton of fun. It makes you think it's a cover shooter, but if you play it extremely aggressively and just use all the powers together, it's awesome. It's a really cool game that makes you feel like a badass, and it's weirdly gory. So if you're into Gears of War style gory games or horror like I am, I think Outriders is a good one to look at. But yeah, that's all the Black Friday deals we have right now. I'm sure as we get closer to the big day itself, we'll have more deals to talk about. I'll be keeping an eye out for SSDs and accessories and anything like that, but if there's anything that you're looking for that you want to get at a cheaper price, let me know down in the comments below. One of the cooler things Sony's been doing this generation is directly listening to fan feedback on the PlayStation Store and implementing changes on their side without waiting for you to download some huge update for the console. So last month we got an update to the store that made it so you could sort by newest games so you could see the new stuff that just came out in the store, because the way it worked before was it would show games that weren't even out yet that you could pre-order in the new games section, and they would take up a ton of space, and it was actually hard to find new games that you might not have heard of already. That was pretty cool, but they didn't stop there because the store just got yet another update, which they tweeted about. And this one's related to the wishlist feature, and it's awesome. So they already had a wishlist system on the PlayStation Store, but they really beefed it up here with some new features. First of all, you can set it so you'll get a push notification on your PS5 and on your phone through the PS app when your game that you wishlisted becomes available. But the cooler and arguably more useful feature that they've added to this wishlist system is that you'll also get a push notification when the game goes on sale. So if you're really waiting for a full edition of a game, like, I don't know, Mortal Kombat 11, you're waiting for the Ultimate Edition to drop to $9.99, like it does randomly once in a while, and you just don't want to pay attention by going to the store every 5 days and checking to see if it's on sale, you can just put it on your wish list, and then you'll get a notification on your phone next time it goes on sale. Now, they're having a ton of sales coming up, obviously, for Black Friday. They'll have a Christmas sale up when everyone gets their new PS5s on Christmas morning. So if there's any games you want right now that are brand new, like a Deathloop or Returnal or Battlefield 2042 or Far Cry 6 or Call of Duty Vanguard, add any game you're planning on getting and haven't gotten yet to your wish list, because when it goes on sale, you'll just get a notification, and that's just being smart. I'm sure it also helps with delays and other release date changes and stuff like that, but I just like when Sony adds new features like this that people are actually asking for. It shows that they're listening to the community, and we've had this feature on Steam for years now. Like, every time a game I have on my wish list goes on sale, I get a notification about it. So I'm glad Sony's catching up there, because I feel like Steam's usually the one that's behind. So I feel like every week we fluctuate between getting excited that there's more PS5s in production that are gonna be available for the holiday season, and then the next week we hear a news story that's like, oh, actually there's not gonna be any PS5s available. And unfortunately, that's the story we have this week. So the projected number of PS5 Sony was gonna have available throughout the end of the year was 16 million PS5s, but they just announced that they've lowered that goal for production all the way down by a million units to 15 million PS5s. And this is by the end of their fiscal year, how many they wanted to have produced and obviously sold. Now, I don't know how much this is really going to affect us, because the PS5 was already hard to get. We're going into the holiday season. Sony just put a bunch of them on 737s. So I don't think you're gonna notice a big change in how available these things are, because either way, they're hard to get. Anyway, guys, that's all the PlayStation news I have for you today. Make sure you subscribe and have your notifications set to all. As always, my name is Jimmy Champagne, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.